Oliver Octopus Takes a Job. Oliver Octopus was an adventurous young octopus. He swam farther from home than any of his brothers. He wanted to go and see what life was like ashore. So he let the tide take him, and he floated lazily on a big wave which swooshed him onto the beach. "This is fun," said Oliver. He climbed up the beach. The first thing he saw was a beach cafe. Lots of people were waiting to be served at the tables under the big umbrellas outside. They were getting very impatient, as there did not seem to be a waiter anywhere. Suddenly, a man came hurrying out of the cafe. He was Mr. Chips, the manager. "Oh dear," he was saying to himself, "what am I going to do? All these people are waiting for lunch and my waiter has not turned up yet."
"Can I help you?" asked Oliver.
"Well," said Mr. Chips, who was very surprised to see an octopus, "I have never had an octopus working for me before, but you have lots of arms. I could do with an extra pair of hands."
"I have 8 arms," said Oliver proudly. "I'm walking on 2 of them, so that leaves me 6 for carrying things."
"How splendid," said Mr. Chips. "Come to the kitchen and I'll show you what to do." The chef showed Oliver a sideboard full of plates of food waiting to be carried to the people outside.
"Do you think you could carry a few of these?" asked Mr. Chips.
Mr. Chips put a clean white folded table napkin on each of Oliver's 6 arms, and Oliver picked up 3 plates on each arm, one in his hand and 2 balanced like a real waiter all the way up his arm. "And if you can do arithmetic, you will know that means he carried 6 times 3 lots of plates all at once, 18 plates." Oliver was the best waiter. Mr. Chips had never seen someone like him in his life. And 18 people were all served at once. It didn't take Oliver long to finish that job. So, when all the hungry people were happy and eating their lunch, Oliver had another idea. He stood outside the cafe and started juggling with 6 plates at the same time. He was so clever that he never dropped a single plate. And the people were so pleased that they clapped their hands and threw coins at his feet. Oliver enjoyed his adventure, but he knew that if he wanted to go back to his family that night, he would have to hurry before the last tide went out. So he collected the coins and put them into a box for poor children who could not have a holiday at the seaside. Then he waved goodbye to everyone and went back to the beach. A big wave swooshed onto the beach and swept Oliver back to the bottom of the sea to his brothers. That was a lovely adventure, wasn't it?